Hello and welcome back to my channel. I'm just kidding. Hello everyone. I hope you are all doing well today on this beautiful Tuesday. I think it's a Tuesday. On my last upload, my last Mangina Monologues upload, obviously I said that I was going to be uploading a few videos for the one look that I did. Upon reflection from that video, of those videos, I was watching them back and I just kind of wasn't happy with the content that I'd created. I wanted to do something different with them, so I decided that I'm going to re-record them at separate times and not rush them. Today I'm recording this video, so this is going to become a Mangina Monologues as well, but this is a challenge that's been set by Let's Talk About Drag, which is the Facebook group that I'm a member of, and it is to look back at 2019, find one of your favourite looks from 2019 and to recreate it and show progression within your artistry. So I'm going to be doing that today. I'm going to be recreating the look. I'll show you the previous look. I'll throw up a screenshot of that, so you can see hopefully the progression that I create. We'll go from there. So the reason why I'm recording me doing my makeup is as well because I've had a few people ask for a video like this, just to show how I do my makeup and where I go with it. Hopefully everybody will get something that they like and enjoy. So fingers crossed. This is a new setup for me. I'm obviously not at home in my drag room, so I'm in my block on camp. So hopefully things will kind of work out. I've got like a horrible curtain background, and I've like literally been titivating and setting up my desk so that I can record with my phone. I've got a mirror right here so I can look in this, and I just don't want things to be encroaching in on the video. Like, so if the mirror suddenly starts slipping in, I apologize. Hopefully we'll go from there. And I don't have any music, which is really, actually I do have music. I'm going to put some music on. No, I can't put any music on. Can I put music on? No, sorry, I'll just do it without music. Let's get this started. I'll be editing this down, and then doing voiceovers, because nobody needs to see the whole thing of, like, how long it takes. Nobody needs to see that, so it will be edited down and sped up, and you'll see little bits and pieces and bits and bobs that come into it. So let's get started. So for this video, I am currently using a optical blurring brush by Urban Decay to apply my foundation. For the foundation itself, I would normally be using Urban Decay 4.0 or NYTA. However, for this video, I ended up using number 7 in colour Cool Beige, as I just needed to kind of get rid of it. So now it's time for contour. I myself use Urban Decay concealers. I go for the darkest shade for my lowlights and the lighter shade for my highlights. I know a lot of people, especially beauty gurus, will be looking at me going, why are you using a brush to blend this out? I don't own any beauty sponges at the moment, but that is an investment for the future.
Pulled off the hair.
Ugh, I'm getting old, man. Yeah. Hello? Ugh, yeah.
That's fine, let's get out. 7-4. I keep pushing, but I just stopped. I think I probably came up for like... You recording?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Come say hello.
Hi.
Sorry for disappearing for a second, Emma. No, this is literally to be uploaded to YouTube.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to edit.
Okay.
Sorry for disappearing so suddenly. Emma was just like, housekeeping. So I had to go open the fire exit to her. And she passed her fitness test though, so everybody, applause to Emma for passing her fitness test.
Woo!
Currently in the middle of highlighting.
Ooh.
How was... Yeah, so your quads are on fire.
Yeah, for doing sit-ups. You know when people pin your feet down?
Yeah.
It's just like a lot of tension like that. Everyone passed except for two people who had to stay behind. But...
Was it Sam taking it?
No. The small Scottish one.
Oh, the new guy.
Yeah. He's fit. He seemed right. He wasn't too strict about it, so that's not good. Right, I'm going to go get ready and... go back to work.
Yeah, some people have to go back to work. I'm on standby, so I can... Oh my God, could you imagine if I got a call and we're like, we need you in right now! It's not happening.
You're like, let me finish then.
Well, this is the thing, I'm night standby, so...
Yeah.
And they won't call me in until at least 6 o'clock, so
that's
yeah.
Fine. You got time.
It'll be fine. See you in a bit.
Goodbye, world. Goodbye, America.
Goodbye, America.
And Brownhouse, darling.
See you in a bit, hon.
See you in a bit.
That's Emma. Oh, she put me off blending. One thing I've never been very good with is contour, so this is always an interesting one to me when I do contouring. And if it goes right, it goes right. If it goes wrong, it goes horrifically wrong. And there's no point in me even like living a life anymore when it goes wrong. And I'm just like, fuck it.
I always got taught when doing contour for your highlight, you make an angel. So on your forehead, you create the halo. Under your eyes, you create wings, as you can see here. And then use the chin as your feet. So create a half moon. With your low lights, you create a three shape. So across the top of your forehead is the top of the three. Across from the top of the ear down to the lip area is the center of the three. And then from the bottom of your ear down to the underside of your chin is the bottom of the three.
I just think I have a very good nose, so, I've got nose hair. Ow! Look at that. That's disgusting. Just pulled that out of the nose. I'm like the most delightfully beautiful person in the world, I'm not gonna lie. But then we all knew that, didn't we?
So here you'll be able to see me applying the halo that I was just talking about at the top of your highlight and contour.
It matches. Definitely need to put some of this around here though. Fuck it, that's it. Makeup done, I have a moustache. I look beautiful. Cause looking a little bit dark on the lips. It's better. Need to stop staring at my own reflection.
It's very vain.
So yeah, so that is, you can see the foundation line already forming, then my wig cap's coming backwards. Be right. It'll be right.
Now it's time to prime eyes. I currently use the primer potion by Urban Decay. Yes, you'll notice there's a lot of Urban Decay in my stuff. And I'm using an Elizabeth Arden eyeshadow brush to add the product to my eyelids. It's just an old brush that I had lying around, and I don't particularly like using the same brushes for two different things. So it's convenience more than anything.
So. What are we going for? We're going for the three palettes I'm using today. Urban Decay, Urban Decay, and you guessed it, Morphe. Morphe Pride one's actually a really beautiful palette, but these are kind of my go-tos. For colours, I mean, just look at the colours in that, it's just beautiful. And it came with such a huge mirror. Oh, no, it's not, it's eyelashes. Fake eyelashes, I thought it was a crack in the mirror, then I wanted to cry. Right, let's get down to business. To defeat the Huns. Don't even ask where that came from. I don't know either. Right then, what shall we go for? I'm concentrating on this. I'm gonna do my left eye first because this is something I always fail to do. I always go in, do the right eye, and then I'm like, bitch, what the hell? So I'm gonna concentrate on doing the right eye today. Left eye first. Ooh, girl, look at how dark that is. God, that's stunningly beautiful colour. See, now, this is the shade Minx that I've just gone in with there. See it. Now Minx looks very, very similar to Harmony on the Pride palette. Like, I think Minx might be a little bit darker, but they are very, very similar.
As I said, the colour I am currently applying to my eyelid is Minx, and that is from the Urban Decay Full Spectrum Palette. I'm now going in with Urban Decay again, and this is the colour Blindsided. As you can see, I use it as a corner piece for the eye, and then I'm going to go under the eye with that as well. And this is the moment that I lose concentration and start doing the right eye before the left. Going in again with Urban Decay, a full spectrum palette, and I'm going in with the colour Gossip. now it's time for eyebrows. So for my eyebrows, I am using the Urban Decay Angled Brow Brush, and I'm dipping into shade Platonic from the Full Spectrum palette. A lot of drag queens specifically will glue their eyebrows down, whereas I prefer to use my natural brow shape that God gifted me with. Unfortunately, God didn't gift me with it, because if I don't keep on top of it, I get a horrific monobrow and just look generally awful. Now I am going in with the Heavy Metal Glitter Eyeliners from Urban Decay. The dark blue that I'm using is the shade Gamma Ray, and the pink shade that I'll be using is the shade Studio. Now to apply some lips. This is possibly one of the oldest products that I own. Urban Decay wise, it's probably expired. I probably shouldn't be using it still, but it's such a beautiful colour, and I could not tell you the shade name for the life of me. Unfortunately, I'm at home editing this and all of my makeup is on base. Lips are possibly one of my worst suited things. I'm awful at applying them. I get very, very agitated very quickly, because they don't go symmetrical, and that really, really annoys me. So yeah, at least I didn't have to wipe them off for this video, and they worked. It was fantastic. I was so pleased. Now it's time to apply lashes. I myself use Illamasqua eyelashes, mostly because I find the lash glue is some of the best on the market. It works for my eyes certainly, and once the lashes are in place, they very rarely move. So they set quickly, they don't move, and they just kind of last all night. Also going to apply mascara. Usually do that before I apply lashes, so I ended up stabbing myself in the eye a fair few times, which was quite painful.
So that's pretty much the look. So as you can see, lots of glitter, stabbing yourself in the eye with mascara. I've done I haven't done a lower lash line. I'm sure I've got that pencil out. Where did I put that pencil? I am confusion.
This is literally what I stole my makeup in.
Don't forget your waterline, ladies.
And it was at this point that Abby realised just how big her eyebrows truly were, and that it was a mistake.
There. And other than a wig, that is my makeup. So yeah, unfortunately I'm looking at it and going, I think my eyebrows are definitely a little bit too big, unfortunately, in this look. It shows progression though, because my eyebrows look a lot different from how they did last time I did this look. And yeah, I think overall my eyes are looking better than they did. So whether that's amazing progression, whether it's progression comparable to other people's progression, but it's my progression. So I'm gonna start getting typed up. This is the other glitter. So I've got like literally all of the glitters. Urban Decay, I'm an absolute whore for Urban Decay. So yeah, I'm gonna get off. I'm gonna stick a wig on. I'm gonna do a Mangina Monologues. I'm gonna hopefully cover up that abomination of a line. And yeah, right. I shall see you all soon. Love yous, bye.